may think that thing looks human, but we're created in the Lord's image. You don't think that's what the Lord looks like, do you?
I wanted the creature to be of a different shape and a different color than any other amphibian creature ever made. So I said, let's be very pure on the beginning and do the creatures purely from a sculptural point of view. But it took weeks and weeks and weeks of sketching on the clay.
It was such a privilege for me to be privy to the designs and seeing Guillermo with the color, and it's like nothing else I've ever known. It's breathtaking.
This one has a little bit of Creature from the Black Lagoon in it. Guillermo loves that character. He's always said that's one of, if not the most favorite monsters ever.
The difficulty with this creature, it needed to be a creature you could fall in love with.
This thing has to be attracted to a woman. This lady falls in love with it. My directive was I wanted to make him handsome.
The design they came up with, my lips are a little fuller, strong jawline. The body they sculpted on me is very athletic. He's handsome in a fish-like way.
I thought it would be a really interesting in-camera technique to use UV light and UV light paint. It kind of produces that bioluminescent glow that sea creatures have.
On an opaque suit like this, a lot of people, when they see it light up, they think there's light bulbs in there somewhere, but it's really not, and it works wonderful.
As makeups go, this is a quick one. They've got it down to 2.5 hours now. That's ridiculously fast for this much of a transformation.
It's a very sophisticated full-body makeup. We've tried to design it to be as flexible and organic to create the illusion of something that's much more fleshy than it really is.
When I saw the creature for the first time, the fins and the gills and the scales, I mean, it looks very realistic.
He's not a monster, he's a god. And the way he moves is like otherworldly.
Doug, who's playing him, is just incredibly three-dimensional. I mean, he brings a real life to this creature. You know, you start to think there's real intelligence there.
It's remarkable. You really do believe you're looking at a real-life merman.